Hey there, I'm Lacey from the University of Minnesota Libraries. I'm here to guide you through some tips about academic library research and spill some tea. Because as a CIS student, you have the same access to all the resources as any other student at the university. Pretty cool, huh? So how do you usually find information? Do you use Google? I mean, we all do, right? But Google is a company whose motivation is to sell advertising to make money. They're not going to help you impress your teachers with scholarly resources that slap. And while using tools like Google and Wikipedia might be great when you're finding, you know, some background information about your research topic, it might be more difficult to find those reliable sources that will take your research project to the next level. Research with the UMN libraries is going to hit different. You have access to millions of resources available online. We know how intimidating this can be, so we'll try to break it down. This is the library's website, lib.umn.edu. You can access it from anywhere you have internet access. You can sign in with your U of M email and password, but if you don't have your U of M credentials yet, you can visit it.umn.edu or just ask your teacher for help. You'll also have to use Duo, a two-factor authentication system. You can either authenticate yourself with a phone call, passcodes, or push notifications with the app on your mobile phone. Once you're logged in, you'll be able to access millions of online resources, so let's narrow that down to the ones that you're interested in. First, think about your research topic. It really helps to do a little brainstorming before you even search the library catalog. Here's an example of a mind map, a brainstorming technique where you start with your main topic in the middle and then expand with additional concepts to help you narrow that big topic down. Just ask yourself the who, what, when, where, why questions to help you get started. Then pick 2 to 3 concepts from the mind map you are most interested in, and think of some keywords that you'll use when searching the library's website. One way to do that is to create a chart with the concepts you chose and some synonyms or like terms. Think of your topic as a conversation among scholars that you will soon be contributing to. What vocabulary would scholars use? How might they be using different words to mean the same thing? In my chart, I've chosen teens as one of my concepts, though it may be more appropriate to use teenagers, adolescents, or young adults. Now that our topic passes the vibe check, let's find some sources. One great tool is this big search bar at the top of the page called Library Search. It searches for books and online resources like journal articles, streaming videos, and more. It will find almost everything we have access to. Let's start by searching our main topic. Look at how many results we get. Way too overwhelming. That's why we brainstorm first. So let's add some of our other keywords to narrow this down. I'm also going to put these in quotes to search as a two-word keyword. Otherwise, the search tool doesn't know we want to search young adults as a concept. Instead, it would search young and adults as two separate concepts. Much better. Now we look to our filters. You can filter the type of source, the date, different subjects, and you can even choose sources that are available online and sources from scholarly peer-reviewed journals, or the sources that have been vetted by experts in the field. Once you've found something you're interested in, click on the link. It will bring you to a page with a short summary of the source. Click on the blue links to view the full text. There are also some other tools that might be helpful, like this one for easily accessing the citation. Next, let's try databases. We have hundreds of databases, and those are tools which help us search for more subject-specific journal, newspaper, and magazine articles. Since they are more subject-specific and only search articles and a few other types of sources, you will see fewer and more specific search results. The trick is to know where to find a relevant database. We have a list of all databases here under Browse All Databases, but I recommend Research Guides by Subject. Here you will find subject guides of all different topic areas. Find one relevant to your topic. Each guide includes a curated list of databases to help you get started with each subject area. We also meet our friendly subject librarian, the expert in library resources for that subject area. And we have a librarian for every subject. Let's try a search in a database. This one is called Academic Search Premier, and you can find it under the Popular Databases section on the homepage. This one covers a variety of topics, but will still give us fewer results to sort through. It looks pretty similar, though we already have the advanced search properties here. Another way we can extend our search and utilize the keywords we brainstormed is by using Boolean search operators. We'll use AND to combine those different concepts and use OR to combine the synonyms or different words scholars are using that mean the same thing. Some databases will even give you relevant suggestions. Use it. It's very helpful. We have a manageable number of results. We can also use our filters again. There's even the scholarly sources filter too. We'll click on the source we're interested in and see the abstract page. An abstract is just a summary of the full text article. Databases will often have tools to help you cite your sources too. To access the full text, we'll look for a PDF or download button to immediately view the full text, but sometimes we see this maroon and gold Find It button instead. Click Find It. Then you'll either click on the blue links again to access the resource, or click Interlibrary Loan if you don't see any availability. Our Interlibrary Loan team will find that resource for you and send it to you in an email. The U of M libraries can help you in many other ways too. Check out Tools under Services. If you need help with your project, don't stress. Make an online appointment with a peer research consultant. They're students trained in library research and can help you with any aspect of your research process. You can send us an email by using this box at the bottom of the page. We'll get back to you within 1 to 2 days. Finally, chat with a librarian 24/7. That's right, I said 24/7.
Good luck, and remember that you can ask us anything. We're always here to help.